Many of the families of those who died on September 11th are still haunted by what they imagine their loved ones suffered on that horrifying day. Now, for one family, that whole image has dramatically changed, all because of one chilling note that only just surfaced recently. Brian Todd is here in the Situation Room. He's got the details, Brian. It's a chilling story.
Chilling is a very good description, Wolf. This note has changed this family's entire perception of how and when their loved one died on September 11th.
Randy Scott was so close to this, the point of impact of the second plane hitting the World Trade Center, that his family was certain.
I was just believing that because the plane had impacted on his floor, that he had died instantly.
Scott worked at a firm called Eurobrokers on the 84th floor of the South Tower. His wife Denise and their three daughters spent years trying to come to terms with his death, but they're now coming to terms with something else.
We all just wrote the same ending, and it wasn't correct.
In recent months, Denise Scott has broken the news to her daughters that she learned only last year, near the 10th anniversary of 9/11. Randy Scott didn't die instantly. This is a note he wrote and somehow tossed out an opening in the tower. Five words, two numbers. 84th floor, West office, 12 people trapped. According to a family friend and published reports, after the note floated down to the street, it was recovered immediately, then handed to a guard at the nearby Federal Reserve Bank. The Federal Reserve, according to those accounts, kept the note safe for years, then turned it over to the National September 11th Memorial and Museum.
The museum then started working with the New York Medical Examiner's Office. It was this smudge on the paper, Randy Scott's blood, that enabled the medical examiner to use DNA technology to trace this note back to Randy and tell his wife about it a decade after 9/11.
Randy's best friend, Steve Ernst, believes Randy got cut by breaking a window so he could get his note out. Ernst went with Scott's widow to the medical examiner's office to identify his handwriting.
When we saw the letter, you can't mistake his handwriting. It's just, that's his writing. So we knew right away that he went down fighting as hard as he could. It was just hard. It was hard to hold back your tears. You know, it's another part of him that just comes back.
Hard for the family to realize their husband and father may have suffered, at least briefly. But there's also this.
That's how he wrote. He wasn't trembling. He wasn't nervous. It just looked like, you know, this is what I got to do. I got to get some help to these 12 people.
Ernst says Randy Scott's note will be kept on display at the National September 11th Memorial and Museum as part of an exhibit documenting the final moments inside the World Trade Center. The chief curator of that museum says they've seen other pieces of paper that came out of the towers that day, Wolf, but she says there is nothing as unusual and as touching as that letter. She says this is extraordinary, this note.
She found out about it, the widow, more than a year ago, but only decided to tell her daughters earlier this year?
That's right. And Steve Ernst tells us that he and Denise Scott both felt that it would be just too tough on them to let them know right away, to know that their father had suffered. It might just be too tough on them. They wanted to wait until the youngest daughter was out of college. She is now. So they broke the news to them earlier this year. Yes.